If you're one of those people who hates all of the pre-installed apps and bloatware that Microsoft includes in Windows these days, and you just want to get a stripped-down version of Windows, then Microsoft has got something for you. It's the enterprise version of Windows, and to be more specific, it's the Internet of Things long-term service channel version of Enterprise, and it exists for both Windows 10 and Windows 11. Now, as you can see on your screen, right out of the box on this Windows 11 24H2 installation, there is basically no bloatware or unwanted apps included, and the start menu looks really clean. Now, that's just one of the many great things about it, but there are also some pretty huge and important downsides in my opinion, and I'll be discussing all of that in this video. So let's get started. Now, first of all, what is the IoT LTSC version of Windows and why does it exist? Well, according to Microsoft, the IoT LTSC version of Windows was designed to run on devices handling critical business functions in industries like banking, healthcare, hospitality, manufacturing, and retail, to name a few. So basically, it was designed to be used on devices where the device has one specific task. Think of an ATM, for example. And nothing should change with regards to the operating system that could cause the device to stop working or crash. Essentially, it's a very stable version of Windows that isn't and won't be plagued by feature updates that changes a user's Windows settings or adds additional bloatware and adware to the system. Because think about it, who's Microsoft gonna target with their ads in Windows on a computer that's inside of an ATM, for example? That's probably one of the reasons why a license for this version of Windows is much more expensive compared to the Pro version of Windows, for example, because they have to make their money some way or another, you know? But anyways, Microsoft has said that they support each one of the IoT LTSC releases for 10 years, which is actually really great. That means you'll still get security updates on this version of Windows for 10 years after the support for the normal version of it has ended. So for example, the support for Windows 10 will reportedly end in October of 2020. But the 2021 IoT LTSC version of Windows 10 will still receive updates until 2032, as you can see on the screen here. So if you can get your hands on that version of Windows 10 and get it activated, you won't have to worry about the support that's reportedly ending in 2025. But that is easier said than done, and I'll explain that a little further in a moment here. Now, another really great thing about the IoT LTSC version of Windows is the hardware requirements. As you can see here, Microsoft gives the recommended and bare minimum specs, and it's actually unbelievable that they can't give us normal consumers a version of Windows 11 that runs on this type of hardware. I mean, a dual-core processor, 2 gigs of RAM, 16 gigs of available storage, and no secure boot or TPM needed. It's insane to think that Windows 11 can actually run on this type of hardware. And on top of that, I think it will run pretty fast too. But that's about all of the info I wanted to cover for now, so let's look at how you can download it. You can download the evaluation version of Windows 11 24H2 IoT LTSC from the Microsoft Evaluation Center in case you want to try it out for yourself. So to do that, you can just follow what I do on screen here. Basically, you can just do a Google search for the Microsoft Evaluation Center and then go to the webpage. Once you're on this Evaluation Center webpage here, just click on this Windows tab up here and then select the Windows 11 IoT Enterprise LTSC edition. On this next page, you should see this Get Started for Free section, and then you can just click on this download link here, and you'll be taken to the downloads page. Now you should be able to download the ISO file, and you just need to select the correct version according to your hardware. So for most people, including myself, it'll just be the normal 64-bit or AMD 64 edition, and you can just click on the link to initiate the download of the ISO file. Now you can use your standard methods like Rufus and Ventoid to create a bootable flash drive of this ISO file, and I'll link some of my guides on how to do that in the description of this video in case you need that. But I would only use this ISO file to install this version of Windows on a virtual machine or a spare computer you have lying around, because here's the first issue I have with this. Microsoft only provides you with an evaluation copy of this version of Windows, so it'll only work for 90 days. Unfortunately, you can't download the full version of this ISO file from any official sources unless you pay a huge amount of money to a licensed Microsoft distributor to get a legal product key and the official ISO file. Now, yes, I'm aware that there are other unofficial sources on the internet where you can download the LTSC ISO files and even activate them, but that is illegal and it's considered piracy, so I'd rather just stay away from that if I were you. I also can't create any content around that for obvious reasons. And to be completely honest, I wouldn't want to have my main computer running on a version of Windows that I installed from an ISO file I downloaded at a dodgy website. That's a massive privacy concern in my opinion, but I could be uninformed, and in that case, please let me know about it in the comments. But anyway, the Windows installation process of the LTSC versions of Windows is basically the same as the normal Windows versions, and you can see me going through the new Windows setup screens that were introduced in the 24H2 version of Windows 11 on screen here. If you want to see a closer look at these new Windows installation screens, I made another video about it, which I'll also link in the description of this video. So we finally reached the desktop here, and this is what Windows 11 24H2 IoT LTSC looks like right after the installation. As you can see here at the bottom right of the screen, this is the evaluation version and the license is only valid for 90 days. Looking at the desktop environment, the only things on the taskbar are the start button, search, and task view, as you can see here. Now you can still hide the search box and the task view button from the taskbar like I'm doing here, and I prefer to have it hidden. You'll probably also notice that there are no widgets and no Copilot options even available in this menu here. That's really awesome in my opinion, and I wonder why we don't have that option in the Home and Pro editions of Windows. One thing I don't like about the 24H2 LTSC version is that Windows Spotlight is enabled by default, which is this wallpaper and icon here on the desktop. This is a form of the adware that Microsoft likes to put inside Windows these days, and it should definitely not be on the IoT LTSC edition of Windows. But you can just disable it and choose a normal picture like you see me doing here now. Now let's take a look at the start menu. Like I've shown at the start of this video, it's really clean. There are no pinned apps whatsoever, and if we have a look at the apps list, basically every one of these entries can be considered essential. I don't know about the Windows backup though, that's just another way to force you into using OneDrive in my opinion. But anyways, taking a look at the task manager here, you can see that it's on about 140 processes, which is a little less than Windows 11 Pro, which is at around 170 I think, I'm not completely sure. But now moving over to the startup apps, Microsoft Edge does start up automatically and is included in this edition of Windows because Microsoft says Edge is an integral part of the operating system these days. So you can just disable it from starting up automatically, and obviously there are some ways to get rid of it, but there are always some remnants of it left on the system and it might get reinstalled with a future update anyway. So just leave it there like we did with Internet Explorer back in the day. Now I'm quite pleased to see that OneDrive or the OneDrive setup application isn't on this list and it's not part of the operating system out of the box. But then again, it could be installed by a Windows update in the future. Taking a look at the size of the installation, it's only about 13 gigs, which is the same as what you get with Tiny 11 Builder and is on par with the 16 gigs of free space that you need according to the Microsoft website. Now if we go and have a look at some of the Windows settings, notifications are still turned on by default, but so is Do Not Disturb. Personally, I don't like the notifications in Windows and I would much rather just have it disabled altogether. If we have a look at the privacy settings, you can see as I'm going through these sections here that this is basically the same as any other edition of Windows 11. The telemetry, activity history, diagnostic feedback data and all of that is still enabled by default and you'll have to disable it manually just like you do on other versions of Windows 11. Taking a look at the Windows updates, you can see that it's busy downloading some security and cumulative updates. If we take a look at the optional updates, it still receives driver updates by default as well, which isn't a bad thing in my opinion. Having a look at the system page, you can see all of my specs and info related to Windows here, but because this is Windows 11 24H2, I just want to have a look at the BitLocker settings here. Microsoft is reportedly forcing BitLocker encryption on users in this version of Windows 11, but it doesn't look like it's enabled here because as you can see, it's still turned off. If we have a look at the Windows activation, you can see that it is activated, but like I said, this is just an evaluation version that works for 90 days. After the 90-day period, you'll be seeing a notification that you need to activate Windows, and your computer will also reportedly shut down every hour. Now look, I like the IoT LTSC versions of Windows a lot, and I wish Microsoft made a similar version for consumers, who can download and activate it legally without having to try and go through unofficial channels. That would make it easier for the average computer user to stay on Windows and not be frustrated with their experience, like many of you are with Windows 11 at the moment. But if you'd like to have such a stripped down and completely working version of Windows 10 and Windows 11 that is not the LTSC version, subscribe to my channel and keep an eye out for upcoming videos, because I'm working on something for you guys that'll almost be like the version of Windows you saw in this video. But with that being said, if you found this video useful, please give it a like, and I'll talk to you guys soon.